Greetings of the day. I welcome you all for 14th session of the course Numerical Methods and Computer Programming. Today we are going to start with the next unit, which is curve fitting. So total 4 sessions will be dedicated for this particular content. So let us start with the fundamentals of curve fitting. So basically, curve fitting is a process of constructing a curve or finding out a mathematical relation, or we can say a function, that has the best fit to a series of data points, possibly subject to the constraints. So that means if you have series of data points which has been acquired through some experimentation by some sensor or by some review or survey, then to finding out mathematical relationship between the input and output of those data points and constructing a best fit curve to those series of data points is considered as curve fitting. So it involves either interpolation, where an exact fit to the data point is required, or smoothing, we can say, in which smooth function is constructed that approximately fits the data. So in the previous session we studied interpolation, where exact fit, or we can say exact line or a curve, used to pass through the data points which we had acquired from the experimentation. But here in regression analysis using a curve fitting, it more emphasizes on questions of statistical inferences, such as how much uncertainty is present in the curve that is fit to a data observed with some random error. So that means when you have a data, and for that particular data, if a mathematical relationship is known, that theoretically, if the mathematical relationship between input and output is linear, then best fit curve will be a straight line passing through origin. But the series of data points which you have acquired from the experimentation may not included or may not lie on that particular straight line. They may deviate from that particular data point. So that means there must be some error exists between the actual series of data points and a point on a best fit curve. So that means if you want to fit a curve or a line, you need to minimize the error between the actual data points and a data point on the best fit curve. So fitted curves can be used as an aid for data visualization to infer the values of function where no data is available. So that means if you have series of data starting from input starting from 1 to 10 with the step size of suppose 2, so that means you have data points as input data points as 1, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, and the corresponding output, if we can consider the change in the acceleration with respect to the input data points, so you will have 5 values of acceleration. So now if you establish relationship between these two input and output parameters, then that can be used to find out acceleration when input is 12. So that means you are predicting the output output value with respect to the function established using the input data. So that is why many times it is called as regression, where output in terms of some prediction is expected. So now we will move on to a short video where concept of curve fitting is explained by giving one example.
Hi, let's suppose that you perform an experiment which involves a resistance connected to a battery, and then you change the voltage of the battery. Let's suppose first you take 1 volt, then 2 volt, then 3 volt, and on, and with each voltage you measure the current. So here in this resistive circuit, the ammeter measures the current, the voltmeter measures the voltage. So if you gather a set of data points by changing voltage and then finding out current, and then you use these data points to plot them in some kind of a graph. So let's suppose the voltage is x-axis, y, current is in the y-axis, and your data points are scattered around in this particular manner. Now, you know from Ohm's law that voltage and current have a linear relationship. That means voltage, as it increases, the current should also increase with the same proportion. So therefore, you're surprised. You're surprised because if you look at your data points, your data points connect to each other in some kind of a zigzag pattern. You expected a straight line, but you are getting a zigzag pattern. Why is that? This is because your data points or your observation points have errors in them. Their errors could be because of instrumental errors. Maybe the measuring devices do not have sufficient resolving power. The errors can also be because of human errors. Maybe you made slight mistakes along the performing the experiments. So the question is, if your data points contain these kind of errors, which makes these points deviate from the straight line that this kind of a circuit is following, so how do you obtain the curve that best represents your set of data points? You cannot just take your pen and just draw a line randomly like that, because this is just guesswork. You need some tool, you need some method which will give you a mathematical way of determining the line which best represents these set of data points, which minimizes the errors involved. So to do that, we're going to discuss what is known as the least square method. So least square method is a very popular method through using which we can draw some kind of a curve which best fit a set of data points to minimize the errors associated with your set of data points. So let's get straight into it. So here, let's suppose that I have a general set of observation points, all right, or data points where the independent variable is x and the dependent variable is y. So these are known, all right. You have these data points, so these are known. What you do not know, what you want to find out, is this line and what is the equation associated with this line. Okay, this is what we are interested in, the line which best approximates your data point and what is the equation associated with your line. So let's suppose the equation associated is, just we give it a general name, fx, and if fx is the function associated with your line, then for each point x1, x2, x3, x4, x5, the corresponding values will be fx1, f of x2, f of x3, f of x4, and f of x5. Now, what we want to find here is that we want to find the error associated with this fx and the actual observation point. So let's suppose for x1, the actual observation point is here, but fx1 is basically here. So the error is this much. So this is an error. Let's suppose this is E1. Okay, so we can say that E1, which represents the error between the actual observation point and the point that should fit into your straight line, best fit line, is known as the error. All right, so here I say that error at x is equal to x1 is nothing but E1, which is equal to y1 minus f of x1. All right, similarly for every single point you will have errors associated with those points. So for example, at x is equal to x2, you will have some error e2 y2 minus fx2, and for all other points, so let's suppose at any general point x is equal to xi, you will have some error ei is equal to yi minus f of xi. Now that these e1, e2, e3 basically represent the errors associated with each individual point, so these are the errors associated with each individual point, what do we do, or what method do we follow to find out the line that minimizes these errors? Now these errors can be positive, it can be negative, it can be positive, it can be negative. So I cannot just add up these errors, because then positive errors and negative errors will cancel each other out, and that would not give us any meaningful information. What I want to do is I want to find the square of the errors. Okay, I want to find the square of the errors, because the square of the errors are always going to be positive. So I'm going to define this quantity. Okay, let's suppose this quantity quantity is capital E, and then this capital E is the square of the errors, and then you sum it over the entire observation data of x1 to xn. So for I is going from 1 to n, if you have n number of data points, you sum up the errors corresponding to each point, you sum up the square of the errors corresponding to each point, and at this is the quantity I define as capital E. Now this is the quantity that is going to be positive, and the further this line is from this data point, so if I plot a line here, then the greater is going to be this particular quantity for this line. So I want to create a line, or I want to create a curve which minimizes this particular quantity. Okay, so I want to minimize capital E to find out the best fit line. So this least square method basically gives us an idea of how I can minimize this particular quantity, which is the summation of the square of the errors. So my objective, the objective to follow in the least square method is to find out this particular quantity capital E, which is basically the summation of the square of the errors, and to minimize it. Okay, the important thing is that I want to minimize this. So how do I minimize this? To minimize it, first let's write it down properly. So summation is from I is equal to 1 to 1. What is EI? EI is nothing but YI minus F of XI. Alright, so I want to minimize this, but before I minimize it, I have some expectation from the nature of this line. Okay, I either say that the line is a straight line, or I say that a line is some kind of a curved line which has a parabolic relationship or something else. Okay, so I need to decide what nature of a line it is. So I'm going to do the derivation for a straight line. Alright, so let's assume that our best fit line is a straight line. So if I want to fit a curve of a straight line in this set of data points, then I can assume that fx can have some kind of a relationship with x as ax plus b, where a is nothing but the slope, all right, and b is nothing but the intercept, all right, and x of course is the set of data points that you get. So fx plus b represents a straight line. If you want to best fit some other kind of a curve, maybe a parabolic curve, in that case you will have to use some other equation. Fx is equal to, let's suppose, ax square plus bx plus c. Okay, but I'm not going to do for parabolic or some other polynomial expression. Let us do or devote this video for a straight line case. If I do it for a straight line, then what does capital E become? Capital E simply becomes summation I is equal to 1 to n yi minus axi plus b whole square. So I already told you that this represents the summation of the total amount of errors associated with your observation data, and I want to minimize this. How do I minimize this? Now yi and xi represent your observational data. What is the unknown here? The unknown is a. All right, I don't know what a is. I don't know what is the slope of the straight line. I don't know what b is. I don't know the intercept. So a and b are the unknown. So I'm going to minimize it with respect to a and b. So I'm going to say that del of capital E by del of a is equal to 0, and I'm going to say that del of capital E by del of B is equal to 0. This is what I'm going to do. If you use some other equation in this f of x, so if you said fx is equal to ax square plus bx plus c, in that case you'll have to minimize with respect to a, b and c. But since in this case I've taken a straight line, so if I assume that fx is equal to ax plus b, so I'm minimizing only with respect to a and b separately. So let's minimize it with respect to a and b and see what we get. So first time I say that del of del A summation of I is equal to 1 to n yi minus axi plus b whole square is equal to 0. To minimize, I say this is equation is true, and then if I find a derivative with respect to A for this equation, then I can simply write the summation I take outside, then this is square, so I can write 2 here, yi minus A of xi plus b, and because I'm differentiating with respect to A, there's a term associated with the multiplicative factor of minus x, so minus xi. Alright, so now 2 goes to the right hand side becomes 0, minus 1 goes to the right hand side becomes 0, I am left with summation of I is equal to 1 to n. So if I multiply xi yi, I get xi yi minus a of xi square minus b of xi, and then this is equal to 0. Yes, so if I write it properly, if I take these two terms to the right hand side and then I flip the equation, I simply end up getting a summation of xi square plus b summation of xi is equal to summation of xi, yi, and this summation goes from 1 to n. Okay, so this is the first equation that I have obtained. This is the first equation that I have obtained by trying to minimize the summation of the square of the errors with respect to a. Now let's try it. So this is the first equation I have obtained. Let's try it for the second case. So if I try to do a derivative with respect to b, then in that case I get yi minus a of xi plus b square is equal to 0. However, here the derivative is with respect to b. Okay, so if I do this derivative, then I can take the summation outside, then I can again write 2 here, which is because the power is 2 here. So yi minus a of xi plus b. Okay, and then b has a multiplicative factor of minus 1, so I write minus 1 here. Okay, now so again 2 goes to right hand side becomes 0, minus 1 goes to right hand side becomes 0. I am left with if I take this, so I'm left with basically summation of I is equal to 1 to n, and then I get yi minus axi minus b is equal to 0. If I take these two terms to the right hand side and then I flip the equation, I simply get summation of, so axi, I is equal to 1 to n, then again I get plus b, okay, summation of I is equal to 1 to n, 1. Alright, so if you add 1 n number of times, what do you get? You simply get n here. So I can just write n, and this becomes summation from I is equal to 1 to n yi. So this is the second equation that you get. So basically you get these two equations, let's suppose equation number 1 and equation number 2, which will minimize the sum of the square of the errors with respect to a and b separately. So let's write down these two equations. So these are a system of linear equations. So how do you solve a system of linear equations? So what we can do is we can just convert the system of linear equations into matrix form. All right, how do you do that? You can simply convert this system of linear equations into matrix form. So basically here xi square is known. All right, xi is the set of data points corresponding to the independent variable, and xi square represents the square of these x values and the summation of that. So xi square, xi, xi, n, xi, yi, yi, these are all known. The only unknowns are a and b. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to write it in terms of matrix multiplication. So in the first matrix, I can say that this consists of xi square, xi, and then xi summation, and then n, and then I can write a, b is equal to summation of xi, yi, and then summation of yi. So this basically represents, so let's suppose this here represents some kind of a matrix, this represents another kind of matrix, and this represents another kind of matrix. All right, so let's suppose that this represents the matrix A. All right, this is known, this contains the observation data points which is known, and this again this is also B, which is also known, and this is, let's suppose I name it as X because X is unknown. So if I do that, then simply this matrix equation simply becomes an equation that looks like AX is equal to B. How do you solve this? Solution of this simply is X is equal to A inverse of B. That's all. So if you take inverse of A and multiply with B, then you get X. So where X1 is nothing but A, which is a slope, and x2 is nothing but b, which is the intercept. So basically our challenge is to construct a matrix of this particular fashion and this particular fashion, and then use this equation to obtain the solutions of a and b here. All right, so
in the previous video we studied how to fit a straight line for a given data. So now let us try to understand the steps to solve a straight line fit. So various steps which are considered for this particular fitting are shown here. So very first step is to prepare the table which gives these values of summation of x, summation of y. So that means summation of x means summation of all inputs, input data points. Summation of y is nothing but input summation of all output data points, summation of x square, and summation of x into y. So you have to prepare a table to find out the four values as summation of x, summation of y, summation of x square and summation of x into y. So now let us take one example. Consider the values of x and y which are given in the following table. Let there be four values of x which are given in the table. So small n, that is number of observations, will be considered as 4. So in the numerical, values of x and y will be given. So here values of x and corresponding y are given as, for 5, x is equal to 5, y is 0.5. When x is 7, y is 1.5. When x is 9, y is 3.5. And when x is 11, y is 5. So now we have to find out summation of x. So if we can take summation of all these 4 points, you will get summation of x as 32. Then we have to find out summation of y. So I will take summation of these 4 points and I will get summation of y is equal to 10.5. Now after this we have to take summation of x square. So that means we have to find out x square. So I will make new column where values of x square will be calculated. So for 5, x square will be 25, for 7 it will be 49, for 9 it will be 81 and for 11 it will be 121. So now if I take summation of all four points, I will get summation of x square is equal to 276. Then we have to find out summation of x into y. So I need to take multiplication of x and y for each observation and then I will take summation of all observations. So 5 into 0.5 will be 2.5, 7 into 1.5 will be 10.5, 9 into 3.5 will be 31.5 and 11 into 5 will be 55. So now if I take summation of all these points, I will get summation of x into y is equal to 99.5. So this is the first step. So in the numerical, values of x and y will be given. Since we are fitting a straight line, we have to find out these four values and then we will move out to step 2. So as we know that the equations which are required to fit a straight line are a into summation of x square plus b into summation of x is equal to summation of x into y. In the previous video, we have derived this particular equation. So here I know the value of summation of x square here as 276, so I will put it here. So 276 into a plus b into summation of x, that is summation of x is 32, so 32b, and summation of x into y is 99.5. you can see it here, 99.5. so I just put all the values in the equation. Similarly, second equation was a into summation of x plus small n into b is equal to summation of y. So small n, how to find out value of small n? That means you have to find out how many observations are there. So here for 4 observations of x, we have 4 corresponding values of y. So that is why, since values of x are 4, that means number of observations are 4, we will consider n as 4. So 32a plus 4b is equal to 10.5 will be another equation. So since we get equation 1 and equation 2, that means 2 equations and 2 unknowns, so you can solve these two simultaneous equations using calculator or by Gauss elimination method. So for this particular case, when I solve for first equation and second equation, that is for a and b, I will get value of a as 0.775 and value of b is equal to minus 3.575. So now, since the best fit curve equation for straight line, we have to, the aim of this particular numerical was to find out best fit curve equation for a straight line. So as we know that equation for straight line is nothing but y is equal to ax plus b. So I'll put value of A here. So 0.775 into x plus value of B, that is, it is minus 3.575. So this will be the final answer. The best fit curve equation for a straight line is given by equation as y is equal to 0.775x minus 3.575. So this is how you have to solve the numerical for finding out best fit curve equation for a straight line. So now let us try to solve some more numericals. Use the least square regression to fit a straight line to the given data. Values of x are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Corresponding values of y are 0.5, 2.5, 2, 4, 3.5, 6 and 5.5. So now equation for the straight line, as we know that it is y is equal to ax plus b, and small n, that is number of observations, are 7, because values of x and corresponding values of y are observed for 7 times, which we can witness from the given data. So now let us make a table. So I'll write all the values of x in the first column, all the values of y in the second column, x into y in the third column and x square in the fourth column. So I'll take summation of the x, all observations of x, I'll get values as 28. Summation of all values of y, I'll get 24. Summation of y is equal to 24. Then I'll take multiplication of x and y for each observation, that is 1 into 0.5, it is 0.5, 2 into 2.5, it is 5, 3 into 2 is 6, 4 into 4 is 16, 5 into 3.5 is 17.5, 6 into 6 is 36, 7 into 5.5 is 38.5. Then I'll take summation of all observations of x into y, I'll get summation as 119.5. Then in the last column, I'll take square of each value of x. So I'll get corresponding of output as 1, 4, 9, 16, 25, 36 and 49. And then I'll take summation of all observations of x square. So I'll get answer as 140. So now we have to put these values in the equation. So summation of x is 28, n is 7 and summation of y is 24. Similarly, summation of x square is 140, summation of x is 28 and summation of x into y is 119.5. So here also we get two equations and two unknowns. So we will solve for A and B. So we'll convert these two equations in the matrix form and we will solve it using a Gauss elimination method, or you can directly solve by calculator. So after solving this particular equations, we get value of B as 0.0714 and value of A as 0.8392. So equation for the straight line, we can write it as 0.8392 into x plus 0.0714. Similarly, this particular equation, the numerical will be solved. So the table of points are given here. For when x is 0, y is 10, when it is 2, y is 12, when x is 4, y is 18, when x is 6, y is 22, when x is 8, y is 20, when x is 12, y is 30, and when x is 20, y is 30. Use the least square methods to fit a straight line to the data point and find the value of y of 22. So that means you have to find out value of y when x is 22, which is not there in the given data. So that's why we have to find out the best fit curve, and then you can find out the value of y when x is 22. So here also number of observations are 7, because we will count it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So values of x and y are observed for 7 times. So that is why small n is considered as 7. So now let us make a table of summation of x, summation of y, summation of x into y and summation of x square. So again I will write all the values of x in the first column, all the values of y in the second column, summation corresponding summation of corresponding summation for x is 52, for y it is 142, for x into y is 1348 and for x square it is 664. Try to understand one thing, if you make mistake by taking summation of x or y or x into y or x square, your answer will be wrong. So though it is very easy, you must take care while taking the summation of all data points. So that all these four values will be correct. So now I will just put values of summation of x, summation of x square, summation of y, summation of x into y in the two equations. So 52a plus 7b is equal to 142, 664a plus 52b is equal to 1348. So again we get two equations and two unknowns. We will solve for a and b using Gauss elimination method, and after this you will get value of b as 12.4466 and for a it is 1.0553. So now we have to write the equation for straight line. So it is y is equal to ax plus b. So I will put value of a as 1.0553 into x plus 12.4466. Now it is asked to find out value of y when x is 22. So x is equal to 22 and we have to find out y of 22. So I will put x is equal to 22 here in this particular equation. So 1.0553 into 22 plus 12.4466. So I will get answer as 35.6632. So that means when x is 22, corresponding y will be 35.6632. So that means when you have data points starting from 0 to 20 and the corresponding output starting from 10 to 30, and then if you want to predict the value of y when x is 22, that means you are doing a prediction, but that prediction must be derived from some standard relationship which exists between x and y for given data points. So according to or based on this particular relationship, that means based on the best fit curve which we have fit for this particular data, the prediction for y of 22 is 35.6632. So this is how a regression analysis or a best fit curve is used for prediction of the performance.